safely. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. We thank God for his presence in our midst this morning. And God is present. We have to be present. Because God can be present and we might be absent. When I say absent, I don't mean physical absence. I mean being physically present, but your spirit, your soul, your mind is not here. That is a dangerous place to be. Amen? So let our minds be here. Amen? Let our spirit be here. Let our soul be here. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Because God is a spirit, and those who worship him will worship him in spirit and in truth. So we connect to God by our spirit. So when you come, you have to come with your whole being. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Last week we touched on the subject of discipleship. We touched on the subject of okay, please, can you cut everything there, yeah? Okay. Now, we touch on the subject of discipleship, and we looked at some of the principles behind discipleship and some of the things, actions that we are supposed to take. Amen? Now, we did a few things here. Not everybody was here, but for those of us who were here, I asked you to take certain actions. And I want to see what action was taken and what impact it has had. Amen. You remember when we lifted the phones? Amen. You remember that? You don't remember?
Their
faces didn't seem as if they remember. Amen. And we spoke about how our phones have become a distraction. We spoke about how the time that we have for the things of God has been stolen, or we've given it away. And so now we spend more time on our phones, on social media, and other things than we spend with God. And that is the reality. And that has to change if anything else is going to change. Amen? And we spoke about the fact that time is crucial. Anything you achieve is because you gave time to it. If you look at your qualification and you begin to think how much time you gave to get it, just look at normal school, from nursery to university. Just think at the amount of time you gave. That would take you maybe a third of your life. And that is daily, you understand? Every day. So we give time to gain knowledge, we give time in exchange for qualifications. And then the qualifications is what earns us the money, isn't it? But even after you got the qualification, you have to give time to get the money. The qualification in itself will not get you the money automatically, will it? No, you still have to exchange time to get it. And so time is crucial. And if we are going to serve God and serve God well, we have to give time. Now, if our bosses demand our time, and they will pay us as long as we are healthy and strong and can think straight. Yeah? That's the deal. When you are sick and your body cannot function, the contract ceases. Yes, the job ends. You are only useful as far as everything is okay with you. When something goes wrong with you, you are no longer profitable to your boss. The contract will end. It is not the same with God. There's a big difference. There's a big, big difference. So, the God that gives us the energy, the strength, the wisdom, the knowledge, the intellect to learn and to serve our bosses, if we look at what He provides for us in order to live our lives and what we give to Him and compare what we give to our bosses or our own entertainment or pleasure, you will see that it doesn't match up. Amen? And so discipleship requires time and requires quality time. Tell your brother or sister, quality time.
Quality time.
Yes, not just time. Quality time. Focus. That is what it requires. Amen? So, most of you spoke about how computers, social media, other things have become a distraction. Who took an action last Sunday or after that and did something and cut something to create time? Who did something? What did you do?
I went to the Manual Bible one. I can't remember what to bring today, but it's on my website. And the group, sort of the time, first to the phone thing, I did. So that was.
So you went to the Manual Bible instead of.
Yeah. And then, you know, the first thing you touch is the phone.
Yeah, in the morning.
That was really hard. So, yeah. And then I set the alarm for. I think you said that when you were speaking that when you pray to God first thing, it's showing Him respect. So
yes.
I set an alarm and I called it respect so that I would know what it meant. And yeah, that was fine.
That was a very good action.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. So she went to take her Bible instead of going to the Bible on the phone. Mm-hmm. Because you cannot be distracted when you take the written Bible.
It's true.
You can't.
It worked.
Yeah, it worked. Okay? And praying first in the morning is showing God respect. It's not just about doing, it's about who is important. You can't go and give all your strength to your boss, and then in the night when you are tired, you yawn. And you say, God, you understand. He does not understand. He does not understand at all. Then you go to scripture. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. No, the flesh was not weak in the morning. It was fresh. You're just giving the strength to your boss. That's why you are saying now that the flesh is weak. In the morning, your flesh was very strong. It's about what was important to you. Okay? So that's very good. Anybody who took an action? Yes, sir.
The phone and all these things that I installed on the other hand. But one thing I learned, the first thing is to pray. I prayed for the first 4 or 5 days. 2 days, for like 2 days I missed. Because normally, I will be honest, I pray when I want to go to work. After I bath, I do deep breakfast before I take my Bible. And I say, Lord, you know I'm going to I changed that. First thing in the morning, maybe before I go to the bathroom, from what we had last week, I make sure I get my quiet time.
So 5 days out of 7 is very good. Clap for him. No, that's very good. For the first week, that's very good. 2nd week, you go to 6, you come to 7. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. The first thing, he changed it. Before, he would do everything. And then when he's going to work, by that time there's pressure. Are you understanding me? So even if you are reading your Bible, you will see the concentration will not be the same. You might read exact chapter, but you'll be surprised when you read something, when you are, your brain is not, you know, stable and you are rushing, and when your brain is at peace, you, the amount of revelation you will get is completely different. And that's why sometimes we say we are reading our Bibles, but we are not getting revelation. And we are thinking, why is it that I'm reading? No, there is reading and there is reading. And there is meditation. That is when revelation comes. Revelation doesn't come just because you are just reading. Okay? So those are some of the changes we have to put in place. Any more? Who did something? Yes. A drastic one. Amen. So the clock went by 2 hours. That's a good example for everybody. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes. Hey, the young people, who took some action? Yes, Judy.
I already said why I deleted.
Yeah, you said it here. Yeah. Said it. What did you say?
The Instagram and Facebook and Showbox. And what I realized was,
what is that?
It's like a free, a free movie.
Free movie.
Free movie.
I don't know about that one. Okay, go on.
So what I realized is, when I got home in the evening, I kind of just had nothing to do. I realized I had so much time of just nothingness, where I didn't know what to do with myself. So I've just been spending a lot more time reading to Hannah and playing with Hannah, reading my Bible, because I've got nothing else to do.
Okay, so when you deleted the Instagram and the Facebook and
the showbox,
you realize all of a sudden you have a lot of free time.
With nothing to do. Yeah.
Which before, it would have given you the impression that you were very busy.
Yeah, very busy.
You see the deception? It creates the impression that you are very, very busy. But actually, you are not busy at all. You are not busy at all. To the point that you have so much free time. That is the difference. When they say that the devil comes to steal, that's how the devil steals. The devil is more interested in stealing your time than your money. Your time with God is more important to him than you going to work. He can allow you to go to work. What are you going to earn that he doesn't? What are you going to earn? How much money? That's not a problem for him. It's the time that you spend with God that is the target. And that is what we have to fight to keep. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So, these things require practical day-to-day changes in our lives. If we are going to be true disciples of Jesus. So, when it comes to spending time with God, the first thing in the morning, it's compulsory. Tell your brother or sister, it's compulsory.
It's compulsory.
It's compulsory. If you respect God, that is. It's compulsory. Disciples don't determine how they live their lives. There are patterns that are set for disciples to follow. And Jesus said we should go and make disciples. I got a definition that was quite interesting. He said that the historical definition of a disciple, but this one, it's not looking at the disciple in the biblical sense. It's looking at the word apprentice. Yeah? An apprentice. You know the apprentice? He said the historical definition is a person who is legally bound to an employer. Legally bound to an employer for a specific time. The apprentice is legally bound to that employer for a specific time with no wage or very low wage in order to learn the trade of the master craftsman. Amen? The apprentice is a person who is legally bound to a master craftsman to work for him with low pay or no pay for a specific time in order to learn the trade of the master craftsman. So, the apprentice goes to learn the trade of that master craftsman, the skilled man. And he gives his time and his energy, gets either low pay or no pay. And the time is fixed. When they go, they will tell you it takes 2 years, 3 years to learn this trade. They will tell you ahead. You know, back home, somebody is going to learn how to either sew or help, they will go to the boss. The boss will give you the things. There will be a list of things. And they will tell you how many years you have to serve. And you will come to the work first and prepare, sweep the place, everything, clean the place before your boss shows up. Yeah. Everybody who has been a mason, plumber, all those people can tell you, they understand these things. That's the only way you learn it. And you commit yourself. It's not, oh, today I don't feel like I'm going to work. No, it doesn't work like that. It's fixed. So we have to understand that. Now, if we call ourselves disciples and we are learning under the master, why is it that the master shows up before we come to work? It doesn't work anywhere like that. No. Mm-mm. There's no way. The apprentice has to be there before the master shows up. But we fix a time and Jesus shows up and we come after him. Because your time is with Jesus. You understand? It's not with anybody. It's not with me. It's not with anybody. Your time is actually fixed with Jesus. And we have to begin to understand those things. So, if that is what a disciple is, then we have to look at ourselves and ask ourselves, are we true disciples of Jesus? Because he wants us to make disciples of all the nations. How are we going to make disciples of all the nations? We can only do that after we ourselves have been discipled. Amen? Then we will qualify to make disciples of all the nations. Amen? When we become true disciples, God can trust us with the nations. Do you understand? He knows we can look after the nations. He knows we can teach them. And so he will bring the nations to us because he can trust us to teach them. Praise the name of the Lord. And give them a good example. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 15. Can you put the scripture for me on this occasion? I want to move very fast. My time is pressed. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 15. Are we there? It says, study to show yourself approved unto God. A workman that need not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Amen. You remember last week we spoke about Ephesians 4 when it talks about God gives unto men. Amen. And some of the gifts were apostles, prophets, pastors, teachers, evangelists. Yeah? For the equipping of who? The saints. For the work of the ministry. For the equipping of the saints and for the work of the ministry. Okay? So, the pastors, the evangelists, the teachers, and the prophets have been given for a purpose. And their purpose is to equip the saints. That is you and I. That the saints can do the work of the ministry. Amen. So they disciple the saints, and the saints can now disciple others. And the work of the ministry we looked at in the book of 2 Corinthians is the ministry of reconciliation. That is bringing people back to God. That is our work. That is the whole work. There's nothing more. Connecting people back to God. Just as we were connected back to God. That's it. But to do that, you have to have the right tools in your hand. Amen? So he said we should study to show ourselves approved unto who? No, not unto the pastor. So that when the pastor asks a question, you can answer. No. He said study to show yourself what? Approved unto God. You see the driving instructor, they will put approved driving instructor at the back of their car. AA approved or something. They want to show that, look, I'm a good quality because somebody has tested me. Me.